How does Tame Impala do it? Like, what the heck is in Kevin Parker's DNA that gives him the ability to carve out such a unique production style and sonic quality? And why are so many of us obsessed, dare I say infatuated, with the sound of his productions? Let's talk about it. Hi there, I'm Marcus Lapp with IndieMusicLab.com. Welcome back to the Artist Analysis series, where we analyze, explore, and extract the underlying musical concepts, the psychological meanings, and the underground subtleties of your favorite artists. Today, we're going to talk about the king, at least in my opinion, the king of DIY production, Tame Impala. Now for starters, I think a big reason Tame Impala has made such a name for himself is his rejection of conventional rules in popular music. He breaks almost every rule that every music educator would tell you. For example, what do we always say is a beginner mistake? Using too much reverb, especially on vocals. What's Tame Impala's response to that rule? Well, he uses an insane amount of reverb, especially on his vocals. Does he care that he broke that rule? Hell no, he doubles down and he doesn't care. He creates in his own world and in his own space. And this is why I've become an increasingly anti-reference track guy. Because imagine if Tame Impala always referenced his contemporaries. You probably would never have heard of him because he wouldn't sound like Tame Impala, and there would be no reason for you to like him because he would sound just like all of his contemporaries. It's his unique style of washy reverbs, weird sonic textures, phasey sounds, and everything that he puts into his productions that make Tame Impala Tame Impala. So if there's one thing I want you to take away from this video, it's this: break the rules. I don't remember who this was, but I once saw a YouTube clip where there was this guy giving a lecture on songwriting, and what he did was, that I loved, is he made everyone in the audience raise their hand and basically make a vow and say, whenever I come across a rule, I promise I will break that rule. That's what I want for myself, that's what I want for you. Get used to breaking the rules. Once you get a taste of that, it's very liberating and it will help you to just be happier in your production. If you're not always referencing things, not always trying to sound exactly like another artist, if you can just be you and experiment, you're gonna come across some really interesting sonic flavors and textures that I think sound better and more interesting than anything else you would otherwise come across. Now, on the more technical production and songwriting side of things, unlike a lot of pop songs, Tame Impala doesn't generally use a singular chord progression throughout the entire song. Often the verse progression is different from the chorus, and the bridge and instrumental sections are especially places where he likes to introduce new progressions. And this is refreshing to hear songs like this because of how we produce music these days. See, the downside of this new era of producing music from loops and on a grid is so much music ends up being a 3-minute vamp with the same 4 chords repeated over and over. Tame Impala rarely does that, and he's always trying new chords for different sections throughout his songs. Not only does he switch up the chord progression throughout the song, but he also changes the melody. Sometimes he'll change the key, sometimes he'll move the song to a new place that comes straight out of left field. Tame Impala is one of those producers where you're never bored, ever. Even if you're 4 minutes into the song, you can't wait for the next section to come because it's gonna be different, it's gonna be something new. Listen to the song and notice how he just pivots and creates new sections after each other that sound almost nothing like the section that came before it. It's really cool, listen. Even the beat here is very unusual. I mean, when's the last time you heard a 4-on-the-floor snare drum? Like, throughout the entire song, like, that's the beat. This is the kind of creativity and exploration that makes Tame Impala so special, that makes him so unique. Now, speaking of chord progressions and breaking the rules, another thing Tame Impala does from time to time is he doesn't even have a chord progression. Listen to the song, and I challenge you to tell me what the chord progression is. Feel like a brand new bus.
Feel like a brand new bus.
Now, you could say the chord progression is still there, it's just, you know, implied, but I don't think that that's necessarily an accurate way of thinking about it, because the bass line kind of replaces what would be your chord progression, and then you've got all these other, like, choir sounds and synth arps doing their thing, but there's not a clearly defined progression. Again, this is another reason why Tame Impala's productions are so unique. It's like, every song has a chord progression, and then Tame Impala's like, yeah, I'm just gonna make a song without a chord progression, just for fun. It's this dismissal of the rules that really make Tame Impala stand out, and that's also what really helps give him that psychedelic qualities, because he's always exploring and trying new things with his different sounds and his different approaches, and it doesn't sound like a run-of-the-mill pop song or anything like that. That's what gives it that flavor. If I had to narrow Tame Impala's plethora of unique musical abilities, and I had to pick just one that I think makes him so great, I think I'd go with the quality of his bass lines. Not just the bass lines in isolation, but the way his bass lines interact and counteract with the vocal melody and the other instruments. He has an unbelievable feel for making compelling bass lines. He takes a very melodic approach to his bass lines. He's not just trying to follow the chord progression per se, rather he's creating counter melodies with his bass, and that in of itself makes his productions wildly more interesting. Have a listen. I was happy just listening, no intention to be mentioning. His bass tracks are also very well mixed. You can always hear it, it's always there. There's enough of the mid-range and the high end that you can hear it. It's not lost and drowned in the mix. Which, pro tip by the way, one of the best ways to make your bass sound come forward in the mix is by using saturation. Just throw a bunch of saturation on there. That will add in some distortion in the mid-range and the high end that will help that bass instrument cut through the mix much better. Now, Tame Impala is no stranger to using really heavy doses of audio effects. And he uses effects to really shape what you perceive as the Tame Impala sound. But it's not just any effects. There are a few key effects that he uses over and over again, and that results into the sound that you hear when you listen to his music. These effects include heavy saturation and heavy compression on the drums, tons of slap delay, reverbs, and chorusy effects like doublers and flangers on the vocals. And finally, effects like flangers, phasers, and choruses on his synth sounds. That is especially what gives his music that psychedelic phasey sound that you hear. That comes from putting phasey plugins on his synth tracks. There truly is only one Tame Impala. He is on an island by himself, but clearly he's there on purpose. Going back to what I mentioned earlier, I think the one quality that makes Tame Impala so great is his defiance of the rules. It's like he's intentionally breaking every rule he can find. And mind you, he makes pop music. So he's also basically giving the middle finger to people who say pop music is always overly structured and not creative. As a creator who pretty much does everything himself when it comes to his productions, he truly is one of the most competent DIY artists of today, and I have an incredible amount of respect for the way he approaches his music and his insane level of creativity. Alright, thank you so much for watching. Now, if you enjoyed this video and you want to learn more about production and the process and what that looks like, I've got a free guide. It's called The 5 Steps to a Spotify Level Production. This guide will give you a detailed plan to make your next song so good that it could fit within a curated playlist on Spotify. That's the goal. That's what I want for you, and I truly believe this guide is going to help you get there faster. Again, it's absolutely free. Link is in the description. Thank you so much for watching. Have an amazing day. Happy music making.